This is the Evil Never Dies podcast midweek show. Keep it evil, everyone.
The Evil Never Dies podcast.
What's up, evil ones? Welcome back to the Evil Never Dies podcast. I'm Brett, and this is episode 270, midweek show. So what's everybody up to this week so far? Nothing good here. It was 106 today. Well, at least that's what my truck said. So yeah, it's hot here in Texas. All right, this week I was going to do a certain album, and then I texted Carl and told him what I was going to do, and he said, that's bullshit. That could be a full episode, which he's probably right, so I decided not to do it. So tonight, I am going to be discussing and reviewing Queensryche, Rage for Order. And this is their second studio album. It was recorded in late 1985 through early 1986 at MDH Studios in Bellevue, Washington, with Le Mobile Remote Sound Studio. I'll get into that here in a bit when I start talking about the album itself. Also at Mushroom Studios in Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada, and Yamaha Studios in Glendale, California. Genres are heavy metal, progressive metal, glam metal, and they even got goth metal on here, which I don't really think this is considered goth metal. Length of the record is 45 minutes and 42 seconds. Released on EMI America Records. It was produced, engineered, and mixed by Neil Kernan. Assistant engineer Dave Ogilvy. Rob Porter and Keith Cohen were also assistant engineers. Howie Weinberg mastered the album. The album concept was done by the band themselves. Moshe Braca was the photographer for the album art. Henry Marquez, art direction. And Glenn Parsons did the design. Band members on this album are Jeff Tate, lead vocals and keyboards. Chris DeGarmo, guitars and backing vocals. Michael Wilton, guitars, backing vocals. Eddie Jackson on bass guitar and backing vocals. And Scott Rockenfield on drums and percussion. Additional musicians on this record, Neil Kernan, the producer, he played some keyboards. And Bradley Doyle ran the emulator programming. And the album ended up being released on June 27th, 1986. And it peaked out on the Billboard Top 200 at number 47. And in the UK, it peaked out at 66. And it ended up being certified gold with 500,000 albums sold. And that happened in 1990. Now, they went totally a different way with this record compared to their EP they put out and their first album, The Warning. Those were a little bit harder than this. A lot of complex structures in this, and they've added way more keyboards to the mix. Lyrically, they're about the same. They talk about the social, personal stuff. political stuff. Talked about the dangers of artificial intelligence. They were trying to warn us from way back in 1986, I guess. So they used a lot of robotics on this record through the use of staccato rhythms, and did some vocal effects with Jeff Tate's voice. A lot of reverse echo on this record. And they changed their look. Their management, I guess, insisted on them changing their look. So they went with like more of a glam rock, glam metal look with pinks and stuff like that. Because before they were just basically just leather jackets and blue jeans and t-shirts, you know. So, I don't know. Should have just stuck with the leather look, I think. And they also had perms. Except for Jeff Tate, he had some sort of goofy looking pompadour thing going on. Ah, the 80s. Don't you love them? All right, let's go over the track list here. Side one, track one, Walk in the Shadows, and that was released as their third single off the album in, I believe, August of 1986. Track two, I Dream in Infrared. Track three, The Whisper. That's a ballad. Track four, Gonna Get Close to You. And that is actually a cover song by pop, or Canadian pop artist, Dalbello. Track five, The Killing Words. Oh, The Whisper, too. That was also released as a single. I'm sorry. And so was Gonna Get Close to You. That was released as the first single. And I'm not a fan of that song. Just telling you right now. Like I said, track five, The Killing Words. Track six, Surgical Strike. On to side two. Track seven, Niu Regal. Track eight, Chemical Youth, We Are Rebellion. Track nine, London, which I guess that's Carl's favorite song off this album. And track 10, Screaming in Digital. And track 11, I Will Remember. That's a very somber song. Not a bad song. All right. And then in 2003, they reissued this album with some bonus tracks. Track 12, another version of Gonna Get Close to You, and they added a bunch of stupid-ass drum editing in there. It sounds like a frickin' dog barking. Oh, not a fan of that song. Track 13, The Killing Words. That was a live version recorded at the Astoria Theater in London, UK on October 20th, 1994. Track 14, I Dream in Infrared. Acoustic remix they did in 1991. And track 15, live version of Walk in the Shadows at Madison and La Crosse, Wisconsin on May 10th through the 12th, 1991. And that is the track list for Queensryche's Rage for Order. When I was talking about the drum tracks earlier, I guess they pre-recorded all the drum tracks on this record in a tunnel to get some effect that they wanted to use. And his drumming's great, it's just the effects not a big fan of. So, all right, moving on to the tour. They actually had a pretty good tour cycle for this. 7 months out on the road. They opened up for Rat, AC/DC on the Flick of the Switch tour, Ozzy Osbourne, and then they did a European tour with supporting Bon Jovi. So we all know he was very popular back in 1986. Well, that's about all the info I got for this album, so now on to rating this thing. I was in the Army when this album first came out, and I was very disappointed compared to their, like I said, the EP and the their first full length, The Warning. Not impressed at all. I don't know, maybe it's the keyboards, heavy keyboards, and the electronic stuff that they did on this album. I don't know. Sometimes I like that stuff, but I wasn't a big fan of it back in 1986, you know, so it was just strange to me that they would go this direction. I don't know how they went from this to their next album, Operation Mindcrime, which is probably in my top 10 albums of all time, so I don't know, but with that being said, I can only give this album a 2. I'm probably going to catch shit, but not a big fan of this record, so. All right, that's all I got this week, guys. Join the group. We're getting some people in that group now. Lots of people are posting stuff, so join the group. And you too can be an evil one. hit that like and subscribe on the YouTube if you would. Reviews are always nice on the audio side on Apple or Spotify or whatever. Would be greatly appreciated. And I don't know what we're going to do this week. I think we're going to have a Season 3 finale show where we're just going to shoot the shit. So, all right, everybody. Thanks for watching and listening, and we'll talk to you Sunday. Stay evil, everybody.
We found the one I was my caller. The scene is not- night to look at shadows sweating on the wall. I get excited when I hear footsteps in the hall. Watching you. I'm dial telephone each and every afternoon. I await by your door.